Hey guys, it's Huff. I am back again and I am filming another project collaboration video. This one sort of came along a little bit later, but I decided I was going to jump in a way. Probably not the same way that other people in the project are doing it, but we'll just. So this project is similar to a project that was done last year, which was based on television shows. This one is based on cartoons and animated shows instead. It's Project Pan. We are putting down 50 cartoons, animated shows, and then picking 10 of them and picking items to pan that fit in with those particular cartoons. Which cartoons we pick is completely up to us. And what items we pick is completely up to us as well, which is why I'm doing samples and small items on the whole, except for one. One of them's not small. The rest of them are small because I'm already doing a 20 in 2020 project. So I thought I would do something a little bit different, use up some samples. Some of them are going to be much easier to use up for me than others. Some of them are a stretch for them to fit the particular cartoon that I've assigned to them, but anyway. So I wrote down 50 cartoons in my old book, and then I used a random number generator to pick my numbers. So let's get into this. Oh, but this was created by Steph, who, of course, I will leave her linked down below. Anybody else who's doing it, I will leave them linked down below too. If you decide to do this, let me know so I can link you and also so that I can watch a video. So the first one I picked was number 17, which happens to be My Little Pony on my list. So for My Little Pony, I picked a couple of face masks, mainly because they're cute. My Little Pony. So the first one is this one from Esfolio. This is the a collagen essence mask. It's got a little cute little pink piggy on it, and pink tends to make me think of My Little Pony. The other one is the unicorn hologram mask, unicorn glow hologram mask. I got this from Lena in a giveaway that I won from her. It's from Sue, I think it is. Yes, supposed to make you look kind of creepy. But it's a shiny mask. And because it's a unicorn, I figure it worked really well for My Little Pony. So that's what I picked for My Little Pony. Second, we have Inspector Gadget. That was number 33 on my list. So for Inspector Gadget, it was actually kind of hard to pick. But I've had this thing in my stash for several years now. It's never been used, never been opened. I believe it's a mask. I'll get it out and show you. It's the weirdest thing. I've taken this out of the packaging several times because it's so weird looking. So basically, it comes like this. So this bit here is a face mask. It comes with this. I'm assuming you're supposed to squirt the stuff on the mask or something, but I don't know, and I'm gonna have to do some research. But apparently it says 23 years old, and it also says no more cosmetics and that the gel can detoxify the skin and enhance the immune function. That's pretty much the only English on here except for the 23pack.com website. But I figured this worked for Gadget. So I will pack that back up later. That's what I picked for Inspector Gadget. It's basically another mask. There are quite a few masks in here, which is kind of stupid of me because I suck at using masks. But anyway. Alright, the next one is number 41, which is the Yogi Bear Show. This one is a total gimme. Like, I should have no problem using these up. I have two Pawpaw body wash samples. That should be two showers right there. These are literally like 2.5 mil samples. In fact, that might almost be one shower. But I'll just use one at a time. But those, and also some Pawpaw Pure Gel. I have actual packets of this stuff, like tubes of this stuff. This is a little sample of it. It doesn't really feel like it's got anything in it, but apparently it does. But that one should be pretty easy to use. I mean, I could use it right now and be done with it. Number 16 was the next number I picked, and that was Ben 10, which my daughter used to watch all the time. So I picked It's a 10 Conditioning Collection. It's another one that I got from Lena. It has a shampoo, a conditioner, and a hair mask. I reckon, I mean, my hair's not as long as it used to be, so I reckon I could probably get two uses out of each of those at least. I think they're 10 mil samples, so yeah. But that's another one that's pretty much a total gimme. Like, there should be no problem using it. So. Then we had number 12, which was My Hero Academia, which I hear about all the time, but I've honestly never watched. I know about Deku and Torodiki, or something. Apparently it's my son's girlfriend's favourite character. And I know that Nerdy Crafter really likes Deku. But other than that, I know nothing about My Hero Academia. A lot of with the cartoons I wrote down, I just wrote down cartoons as they came into my head, not whether I'd watch them or not. So for that, I picked this little, it's a sample pack. It has some kind of Asian language written on it. I'm not trying to be racist. I don't know which Asian language it is. It could be Korean, Chinese, Japanese. I don't know. It has writing I can't read on it. It's called Benton. I don't know where they're based. It doesn't tell me in, oh well, yes it does, Korea. So I don't know where My Hero Academia is set either. It's probably not Korea. Anyway, this comes with six little samples inside it. The yellow ones are a hand cream. That'll be easy to use up. The two white ones are some kind of redness gel. And the two black ones are a fermentation eye cream. So basically, they're just an eye cream. They don't tell me what size the samples are. I'm assuming a couple of mils each. Probably a couple of uses for the eye cream. Whoops, sorry. A couple of uses for the eye cream and the gel, the hand cream. I don't know. But I figured it sort of fit. Maybe. Don't shoot me. Next was number 24, which was Animaniacs on my list. I had a real time trying to work out what I was going to do for this. And in the end, I decided I was going to go sort of with Dot. Now, Dot has a flower on her head all the time. So I picked, and yes, I'm aware of the fact it's not a rose. However, I picked rose-scented things. So I have this rose Eau de Toilette roll-on. I really suck at using fragrances, so this will probably take me all bloody year. It's in some kind of rose scent. I like rose scents as long as they're not too overpowering. And then I have three of these moisturizers. I'm not sure how I ended up with three of them. I have three samples of the Palmolive Oil Infusions Rose with Macadamia Oil. So I'm going to attempt to use those, which, I mean, Seriously, it shouldn't be hard, but I'll probably make it hard. Then I picked number 7, which was Batman, and I actually picked a bunch of stuff. This is the section that has the most in it, is the Batman one. So I have the crystal black sheet mask. This is pregnant cucumber. It's supposed to be moisturizing. I have the natural activated charcoal sheet mask from Essenza. I got that in a yellow box. I have the black charcoal express wipes to take off makeup. Apparently they're in-flight approved. What the fuck do they mean by that? There's only 5 in there. It won't be hard to use those on. And lastly, I have some Biore. In fact, I have one. Looking in the box, it appears to only be one. I have one Biore. Two Biore charcoal strips for the nose. Why did I pick those? Because they're black, like Batman. Literally the only reason I picked them. The next one I picked was number 3, which was Tom and Jerry. So I picked this. This is the Hawaiian Tropic Duo Defense Very High Protection Sunscreen Lotion SPF 50. And you're thinking, why did you pick that? Duo. Literally, duo. Tom and Jerry, they're a duo. This came in my last bell box. Should I have one at the post office waiting for me? Never mind. That's why I picked this, because it says duo defense. Probably because this is a UVA and a UVB protection, which all of them should be, so it shouldn't be a selling point. But anyway, apparently it has a protective anti-pollution layer. The next one I picked was number 19, which is the Rugrats. I picked 2 items of this. One of them is a face wash, which is the Purity Philosophy cleanser for face and eyes. I'll probably go stick this in my shower and use it in my shower. 30ml sample, shouldn't be too hard to use up. And the other thing I picked is the Palmolive hand sanitizer in lemon and white citrus. I don't use hand sanitizers a lot, I do use them occasionally. I'll just try to use them a bit more often. The reason I picked those 2 items is because the Rugrats are kids and kids are messy, and often after touching a child you want to sanitize yourself. So that's why I picked those 2 cleansery, sanitizing type products. And my last one I picked was number 20, which was Ren and Stimpy. Again, not easy to pick something for them. But I decided I'm going to go with this completely new, never been used, completely full bottle of micellar water. Actually, I could use this up quite quickly if I wear makeup a lot in particular. This is a 2-phase one, so you can see the little blue layer and it's clear at the bottom. It's one of those ones that you shake it up and then use it. I find these 2-phase ones are particularly good for removing eye makeup, as opposed to, because the blue is usually an oil which helps break down eye makeup. And you can sort of see it when it goes back together, you can see the little beads of oily stuff in it. So that is what I'm going to be using. And that is my pick for Ren and Stimpy. And also, they're another one, after watching them, you kind of want to clean your eyeballs. So those were my 10 picks for this project pan, where I'm focusing on minis mainly and samples. Once again, I will leave Steph, who designed this project, and anybody else who's doing it, linked down below, as well as the Geeks and Beauties if you want to join them on Facebook. If you want to subscribe, click down there, click the little bell so you get notified of when I upload new content. Leave me a thumbs up if you like Project Pen type videos, and leave me a comment down below. I will like your comment, and I will answer any questions that you ask me. And I will see you in the next video. See ya!